plant breeding is the key cornerstone of modern agriculture. Unless we have the very best varieties that give us the capacity to breed high-yielding crops, there's not the profitability and there's greater risk in farming. 10,000 years ago or even longer, nomadic tribespeople and then village-based tribespeople would go out and they would harvest and retain the highest yielding, the largest heads, those heads that didn't shed. And from that more nomadic and roaming lifestyle, we moved into agrarian systems that were much more around villages and maintaining areas for cropping. Over the next 10,000 years, slowly changing the genetics, building up the very good genes that ensured crops that could be harvested, reaped, harvested, threshed, stored, and would make good quality food, evolved into what is now a much more scientific and much less risky system. We now breed varieties that are resistant to disease, resistant to insects, high yielding, high quality, and are much more improved and much more profitable than the old grasses from 10,000 years ago.
Frost is a very good example because in breeding for resilience to frost, it's sort of like the Holy Grail. There are really no magic bullets there. And so one strategy with breeding for frost tolerance is actually breeding for frost resilience. We're seeing frosts are becoming even more intense and much more variable, but there are other traits in there.
We are not talking about targeting one or two or three genes, but many, many genes that underpin many different traits that our growers and our markets demand of our commercial elite varieties. And so breeding really is about identifying new genes that are superior to the old genes and developing methods to incorporate these new genetics much more efficiently and cost effectively in delivering improved varieties. And with that, the new genes must come with improvements that don't come with associated costs. And so it's very much a juggling act and a numbers game.
So to me, genetics and breeding is doing an amazing job of building the potential, building the platform, and then the agronomy comes in to realise that potential. So two go hand in hand, but very much built on the cornerstone of good genetics and breeding.